Anyway, the horror show continues. There's video pops up, if you said, because you're always on there. Yeah, I'm keeping a very close eye on Taylor's garbage now. It's very educational. If you said, what happened? I already spotted a problem. It said, how to play with your dog. This is so rich. I want to give you credit, Aaron. The validation that I get from your work is startling. This guy knows what the shakeoff is. You can't read dogs at all if you don't notice the shakeoff. It's one of the most obvious signals that they're giving. Oh, hi, King. Oh, this is so good. There's a sneeze in there too. The sneeze is the precursor to the shakeoff in this dog. So if you said it was trying to tell them with the sneeze, but they didn't see the sneeze. Yeah. It's just unbelievable. It becomes very, very predictable, and I'm sure you're starting to see that now. It's like you can see, you're watching it. It's almost like, it's like almost like a action flick. You can see the shakeoff is getting ready to happen. Unless they cut the film off. And if they were smart enough to cut the film off, they'd be smart enough not to get the shake off. Anyway, let's take a look here. If you said, what is it? It's called, oh, there's a bad connection because there's a hurricane. It's called How to Play with Your Dog. If you said, I said, holy God knows. So now what we got, look, this shit's unbelievable. It's fucking unbelievable. I didn't see this part a second ago. If you said this is how to kill engagement, he's now taking the cot that it's supposed to stay on and scooting it at the dog. If you said, I've never seen you pick up the climb and do that. If you said, it looks like the dog's keeping the guy outside of his reactionary gap, absolutely. I want you to notice that, King. It's not even in the shot. It's keeping the guy outside its reactionary gap. If you said, now it's thinking of sort of, now he hits it. Oh, hi, Gypsy. Now he thumps it in the chest. If you said, it's not sure what to do. So it comes up with that strategy, just like they do when they feel, now he rubs the head. If you said, now it looks like he's trying to get it to mount him, doesn't it? Now it's gone. It's hard to tell. It looks like it's doing the shake-off. That's a strategy, though. It's kind of bouncing around, getting the whole thing in motion. If you said, look at the tail. There's the shake-off right there. Did you see it, King? Look at this guy. Oh, my effing God. Nothing I say. Look at this crap. All right, watch. It gets worse after this one. So it does that little play bow thing. And if you said that usually precedes them sort of taking off, and yeah, if you said that looked like the shake-off, it did. If you said now it's gone, that's the shake-off. Am I wrong? They're not able to hide their emotions. That's what you need to understand. You said, it looks like he's got the hair up a little bit. There's the shake-off right there. Am I wrong? Look at this guy. He's squatting down with his arms wide open. If you said, well, they usually run right to the people. King, he's now crawling towards the guy, the dog. If you said, I see you out there all the time doing that, Kelly. You're on the ground crawling around. If you said, this is a full-grown man. If you said, it's about to run drop tail. It's about to run drop tail. And if you said, what's that? Watch the tail. There's something, I've got a bunch of videos of it, but there's something they do called run and drop tail. If you said, what does the running drop tail mean? It's inevitable. I'm going to get my ass beat by this dog and I better just take it. They just sort of see it as a foregone conclusion. So they get this drop tail thing and they just kind of wait for the ass beating. It's what, I promise you. Okay, so now he's there. If you said, but should we tell our clients, do that, force yourself into its face as it pulls away? Look at that. If you said a lot of lip flicking and now it's gone. It's disturbing. If you said, I'll gladly pay somebody to do this with my dog every day. No, I didn't see this part before. Somehow I skipped over this part. If you said, it almost looks like it's got the hair up a little bit. Doesn't it? All right, look, now it goes back over by him, dodges away. If you said, well, I was going to work for your recall. The fact that Nick White copied that squatting and throwing the hands open from the final scene of Lassie Come Home, and they all do it. It's unbelievable. He says now he's actually defaulting to go onto the cot as in his attempt to get away from him. Gone. It gets worse, I want to promise you. It gets worse after this. Now he's sitting, legs spread on the ground. And then putting his face right in his face. If you said, is that a good idea? I wouldn't do that with that dog. You don't know these dogs. If you said, well, it's wagging its tail, it doesn't mean anything. I mean, this Taylor is, the fact that he's been told about this shake-off. If you said, that's a good idea? No, it's not. King knows it too. You don't ever sit on the floor. That Kiko pup does it. Zach George does it. They all do it. You've got to give the impression that you're going to move away if you want to maintain engagement. If you said this dog is going to go away. Okay, forget about this one. It gets worse after this one. I want to show you the sneeze. The second I saw the sneeze, I was like, oh my God. Because the sneeze preceded. And if you said they're trying to tell other individuals, it's a signal, but it's not anything they're intentionally trying to tell. All right, look, now he's hugging it around the neck. If you said, look at the tongue. Look at that. Look at the tongue. Okay, this one is just ungodly bad. Look at these people. If you said, well, that's how they play with another dog, and they run away, and all the dog, the only thing this dog is going to figure out is how slow this guy is, because he's parked his ass on the floor. Look at him. They sit there and hit the floor, crawl around on the floor. If you said, now the dog's doing zoomies, you'll never catch this dog. No. Gone. Reactionary gap. Anytime you see them facing somebody like that and being this is their reactionary gap. It's not even something they're conscious of. If they're backing up and looking at somebody like that and there's any kind of backing away, look at this guy. There's your reactionary gap right there. If you said, why do those dogs act so friendly? They do something called playing the affable card. So it's just a strategy that they have. Gone. If you said, should we do this? Why do they have leashes on us? That's what I don't get either. I mean, I never saw anybody until I started going online. I didn't think there was such a thing. he said, that's not going to encourage the dog to jump and do all these things. Okay, so let's go to the next one. You probably have to watch it back. There's little shake-offs and stuff in here. Oh, my God, this is. So now you better start being careful when you start this shit with a dog like this. Look, the dog is uncomfortable from the beginning. It's putting his face in his face trying to stop him. It's trying to use his face. He's going to slap it in the hip. It's now putting its ass to him. It slaps its hip. It's going to jump on him. That's what they do. He's going to push it away. Now he's petting it for jumping up. If you said, I don't feel a shake-off coming, my dear. Look at the head. Now it's going away. There you go. There's your great big head-to-toe shake-off. Looks at the guy and gone. I can't make this up. This is the most overt signal that dogs give. The fact that these people don't see it or think it's an incident. He now takes it outside and starts doing it. If you said, should you play fuck around with a dog like that? It doesn't look like the type of dog that you would want to play fuck around with. If you said, well, it's just a boy playing with a dog. This is Taylor telling these people to do this. The one guy keeps looking at the camera like, more, keep doing it more. They now go to their outside area. I want you to understand Taylor's now on and on with his world-class trainers. You expect us to believe, Taylor, that world-class trainers are gravitating towards a strip mall in some little town in Virginia with a 4x4 outside area? Again. If he says it's going to jump at him, yes, gone. It's going to jump at him. If he said, who wouldn't want that? Okay, now we got our sneeze. They're really teaching this girl wrong. Sit on the floor with this pit bull and just on and on and on. You can already feel it coming, King. If he said it does it once, no. It's already doing it when her hands are there. It's a very distinct sneeze. If you said, if you were there in the moment, it would be easy to miss if you weren't filming it, right? There. Did you see it? It would be easy to miss if you weren't filming it. And you were just doing that. I mean, and... All right, watch. It's going to walk away. It's a very... And... Choo! So if you said, that's your first red flag. Stand down. Stand down. It doesn't have allergies. It is allergies in a sense because it's allergic to what you're doing. If you said it's going to get worse, yes. So now she's stationary. If you're trying to give her signals, they always do that put the butt to them thing. And people say, oh, it wants butt rubs. No, that's the strategy. They do it to other dogs too. Everything that they're doing with these people in these videos, it can be observed interacting with other dogs too. If you said you want them to believe you're another dog, no, you don't. You want to be distinctly, if another dog gets a bone, they attack them. Exactly. All right, look, so now it's staying an arm's length away. And I want you to understand, King, I talk about that arm's length away thing, and that's how it happens. The dog learns it's now gone. She's over there, left without a date. They just don't get it. Now tap the floor. It's trying to be affable, so it comes back over. Now it's doing the turn the butt thing. It's all textbook. If you said they're mistakenly thinking, now it's turning its head, they're mistakenly thinking that this is it liking it. Mm-hmm. Now they're grabbing the neck, shake off, head to toe. If you said if you counted how many shakes, that's what we should do, King. Promise me. I won't have time in my lifetime, but you're young, that you'll come up with this shake off scale thing. You'll get a computer program. Then we'll just be able to run the video through there and say, it did a level 7 shake-off because it shook. it was only a level one shakeup. And then it'd be like the sneeze. If you said, would there be levels of the sneeze too? Oh, for sure. Okay, so if you said, it's trying to tell her it's done, but she's not getting it. No. It's all right. It's really sad. I mean, it's sad because now they're clapping their hands. You see the difference, though. There's some that just do the head. And then, but not a tailor's. The if you said the booting the butt thing precedes the shake-off. Yes. You see these people all the time. Ask them, oh, does it like butt scratches? Oh, yeah, it backs its butt up to us. Mm-hmm. If some human being was, all right, so it's, she's not getting the hint so big. You could count. You could literally count. I mean, then she still just keeps doing it. If you said, now it's turning the butt again. They're usually turning the butt and turning the head. If you said, no, it's going to try to get away. It's now at an arm's length away. Do you see that? Tongue. This is how they, if you say, why did they go back over? And that girl, Lauren, no, it's gone. They will go back over there with the feet striking and stuff. Just as a strategy. Now it's gone. You said it looked like it did a little shake there. If you said it's done with the shake off. No, it's not. It's saying to itself, okay, now it's doing the neck scratch. And I talk about the neck scratch thing. If you said, is the neck scratch lesser than the sneeze? Yes, if you said, what's lesser than the neck scratch? That's tomorrow's episode. That's what I call that a filler behavior. And it is sort of, now she's clapping her hands to get it back over there. So look at it go, though. Look at it go. Cut. If you said, now here we got this guy again. This is going to get disgusting. If you said, it's again already given the signs. It's facing the butt and curving the head. If the head is twisting, they're turning the butt. If you said, what you're trying to say is all these things precede the shake-off. Yes. These are all strategies to try to keep this from happening. They're not trying to put themselves in a position to do the shake-off all the time. They're trying, but it's not even conscious. I want you to understand their physiological system. We have a barrier in between our physiological system and what we act like. If you said there's FBI profilers that can, or, you know, these interrogators and all this shit that can see right through it, absolutely, but your average person isn't looking for it. These don't have that barrier. So there's no filter. It's... I want you to understand. Now, while I've been talking, this is what it's deteriorated to. If you said, we're looking at a guy in his 40s, rolling. If you said, well, what if the owner is an older person or a small female or children? Are we all doing this? If you said, gone. If you said, I don't see the shakeoff coming, watch. The behavior is a little bit harder to see because it's very convoluted because the guy's got his hands all over the dog, but it's all there. If you said, I feel a massive shakeoff coming, yes. It's trying to get away. There we go. If you said, as I live and breathe, I've never seen a shakeoff like that. That's from all of this. That's how bad it was to this dog. Watch. If you said, I can count how many times it shakes back and forth. There's varying degrees of it. I don't know what else to tell people. If you said, is a sneeze a lesser version? I think there would be some dogs that were more prone to the sneezing thing. All right, look at this, though. It starts at the head, going. Whew. Gone. If you said, but he's pulling it back. Look at that shit. If you said, this isn't playing, this is forced engagement. Anytime that you see dogs playing, and at the end they do the shake-off, it wasn't playing, it was forced engagement. There's the other strategy, the jumping at them. That's what they don't seem to understand. So if you said, now you're going to try to explain to me that we're going to see the shake-off again in these very, very short clips. This dog is gone. It wants nothing to do with this guy. Any kind of bulldogs are hard to animate anyway. The worst thing you can do. He said it was doing the shake off. It looked like it was. There's such a glare on there. Oh, that's Taylor reaching for it. Taylor can't keep his hands off. He's filming and Taylor's big hands coming in the picture. Look, so he reaches for it, it runs away. If you said this is what this is doing is developing this arm's length syndrome thing, yes. They figure out you're stationary, your arm is 3 feet long, and they only have to stay outside that gap. The reactionary gap is different when once they figure out this handler is seated and can't move. If you said, what if you stand up and kind of go like that to them? Yeah, they're going to back up. They're going to say, I need to expand the reactionary gap. These dogs are figuring out. So the one on the cot, now it's kind of being forced to stay there. Okay, so here's the butt, here's the turning the head. It's, King, I want to promise you, everything we're seeing here is just so effing textbooked. It's the most obvious signal that they have. If people cannot see this, so there's the butt. And there we go. If you said what I saw was a dog that levitated off the ground doing the shake-off, and I want you to understand that's the highest degree of shake-off. I've got a couple examples in the group, but they're doing it so much that their feet come off the ground. If you said that's what happened right there, mm-hmm. They're doing it so much. There's so much energy being devoted to the shake-off that they literally come off the ground. I want you to watch. If you said you would not be able to see it, I want you to watch the other one too. It's uncomfortable. It's already trying to leave after his hugging the face. All right, so there's the curved head. There's the butt. Doesn't see it. I want you just to watch the feet. Just look at the feet. Don't look at the rest of the dog. Cindy, just watch the feet. This one's going away now. Now it's doing the butt thing. There's the bent head. There's your bent head. Get ready. Get ready. There's tapping the butt. Now there, it's curling around. It's trying to tell him. It's trying to tell him. And this other one's gone too. And get ready. Boom. Look at the feet. Watch the feet. Wait, no, that wasn't it. That was a different one. All right, hang on. Keep watching. Why, Bella Toto? I want you to watch this dog shake itself off the ground. If you said never sit Indian legged on the ground. I've got a few videos where you find me sitting on the ground. If you said after that, you learn not to do. If you said now that one looks like it's doing the shake off. Hang on, let me go back. That's what you have to say. That would be the highest degree of the shake off. The dog actually levitates off the ground. Their feet, there's so much energy devoted to doing it. All right, watch. Well, it must have been before that. Hang on. Let me find it. Let me isolate it real quick so you don't have to keep watching. It's just a nightmare. The last thing you should be doing is grabbing at their head and ears and doing all these things and putting your face right in their face while you do it. This guy's level of incompetence. If somebody told me what the shake-off was and I went back and saw that every dog I had ever trained was doing it, or that the video I had made yesterday, the dog was doing it, and I was unaware of it. All right, hang on. Now he starts slapping its ass. There's one video, though. Oh, maybe it's that one video. It's probably got to be that one video of Taylor's. But there's so much energy devoted to the shake-off that they actually come off the ground. Okay, stop. There it is. No, that was a half shake-off. If you said, if you watched it really close, there might even be a sneeze. The sneeze is easy to miss. If you said, why? I've seen them where they do the sneeze where the head doesn't even really move very much. Okay, it must have been back here earlier. But they can just, I mean, it's like so subtle. You can't even really, if it's a small dog and stuff. I'm going to isolate the shake off. So it actually does the shake off again. If you say, what are they thinking to themselves? I mean, it just runs away from them. If you said, no, they better hope one of these doesn't get outside and think that, that what they're trying to do is play, because that's what it's going to do. It's just, there's, everything is very classic. You get pet owners all the time that say, oh yeah, it backs its butt up to me to get butt scratches. If you say, what do you think to yourself? Oh boy. This is why the dog won't come to you. I mean, these people just, they can't. So it's, so if you said that's the butt scratch thing, yeah. Do you see how the feet came off the ground? This stuff really, if you studied it frame by frame, that's what they do. That's what they do for, you know, I was watching this crime show thing, and it was about that bombing in Manchester. And they had 16,000 hours of footage that they got from people's cell phones and the surveillance footage and all these things. And they have these people, all right, watch. It's just doing all the classic signs. If you said you there's the bent head. Now he's playing its butt like a bongos. If you said, why do they wag the tail? That breed plays the affable card. It's, that was the smaller version. If you said, if the dog did the shake off, once it sort of physiologically was ready for that, it's going to do it more and more and more. Yeah. This dog is now gone. This one he was hugging and kissing a minute ago. It wants nothing to do with him either. But that's, I want you guys to understand, anytime they're doing the shake off, the bent head and everything, I mean, those are very obvious. Now this dog is gone. If you said these people then are then sitting there. All right, now watch. Taylor's going to reach his gigantic hand down. Watch, watch, watch. He's going to slap it on the ass. It's startling. If you said, how long is this video? Okay, now he's standing here. If you said, now the dog's reactionary gapping him? Absolutely. That's reactionary gapping the guy. That's what I call it. When the dog says to itself, you can't catch me as long as I stay this far away. If you said, now they crawl over there. It's startling. It's such good examples of the shake-off, though. If you said they don't see it. I mean, the one, this is the one with the guy on the ground. The girl, too. This girl, I mean, all of them. Every single one of them, the shake-off was in it. This dog even, I mean, if you look at it in Phasma, you can see these dogs are, look, you can even see, the sneeze is that obvious. They don't understand, it's. If you said that is a dog that is becoming irritated. Bye. Sneezing, scratching, shaking. If you said it just sneezed again, I think it did. If you said, which one do I have that sneezes? Molly does it a lot. If she said she's irritated a lot, yeah, you would be too. If you had to live with Henny and Oliver and Tuffy, you'd be irritated and chew bottom. All right, I think it actually sneezed again. Let me just see. Let me just watch it real quick and see. The fact that they're sitting there smiling while the dog is going away, leaning towards them. So here it starts scratching. Let me just watch real close and see if it sneezes. That scratching is kind of a filler behavior. If you said it's, tread carefully if you see, yeah. Oh wait, I forgot to look, okay. Oh. It did do it. This stuff is great. You've got to watch very, very closely. It starts scratching. It's the last frame of this particular dog. Watch very closely. This stuff is rich. The tongue is kind of flipping around a little bit, which... It stands up and watch what happens. It shows the head real quick. Oh, hang on. Let me isolate it. Just like that. This stuff is just right. If you said a lot of times you see dogs that scratch their collar and then do the take off. Yeah. It is worse, I think, and I told Courtney. This is where you study it frame by frame. And it would be one of those things where you'd say, you know, why couldn't this idiot move the camera if you said Taylor's good at the camera? No. Oh, I saw it. Can't slow it down anymore. Just watch very closely, though. It's going to happen. As it steps away, it's either a shake-off or a sneeze. You can't really see the gloves. Right when you... It was hard to see. This one is the best one, though. This one with this guy. He's rolling around, which what would seemingly be, I don't know what it would be in real time. This is one of the, this is, it doesn't get any worse than that. If you said the dog is not in control of that and it felt better after that, yes, it did. They do. It's in sports, and I don't, you know, it's in all animals. I can show you videos of the pig doing it. I can show you videos of all kinds of horses do it. I don't know if every single animal does it, but I see it in all kinds of animals. It's an operating system that the animal has. I mean, this stuff is disgusting that Taylor is teaching these people. You know, for them to say, the dog is not lying. If you said, and now he's holding on to it and pulling it back over there. It's going flat, trying to get away. He pulls it back over there. If you said this is systemically ruining this, it is. If you said now it's jumping on him, who wouldn't want that? These people just don't get it. Now the dog is gone. It's reaction or getting. If you said that's what Zoomies is in a way. It's sort of like Seinfeld Festivus feats of speed. You can't, that's the one right there. It's doing Zoomy thing. It's, you can't catch me. She said it just did the shake off. That's what it looked like. When you've got dogs and your interaction with them is causing the shake off, if you said pretty soon, if you said explain to me what you see happening, that one dog max, people came, they didn't even touch him. He just sniffed him and did the shake off. Or said head to toe. Head to toe. If you said the memory of them, look at this. They just don't see it. This Taylor's right there filming it and doesn't see it. It's the lips, it's turning the head. It's already presenting its butt. It literally levitated and moved like an inch forward. Did you see that, King? That's what I'm talking about. These are some of the worst shakeoffs you're going to see. What do you do when I say, I'll give you the shakeoff, dog? You're going to see it. I mean, you are going to see it. A lot of dogs have it just habitual. If you say, what do you mean? Well, every time the people put the leash on or the take it off, they do it. So now it's become habitual behavior. A conscious one? No. I want you to watch, though. It literally, there's the head turn. Who plays a dog's ass like a bongo drum? Come on. That was the half shake off. If you said that was before the other one, maybe. If you said they're trying to tell you, they are trying to tell them, but it's not a conscious signal. If you said, but it's a signal that should be picked up by the other individual, yes, absolutely. If you said, what if you kept on and kept on and kept on and the dog attacked you? The dogs would have an argument that I told them and told them and told them. And when they said, what evidence do you have? 400 takeoffs. And they didn't see it. This dog actually levitates off the ground. They don't understand about bulldogs and the affable card. If you said, what if this was a child? If you said, what if you play with them like this, and then they think you're another dog, and then you try to go buy their food, and they treat you like you were another dog? Exactly. No, the second shake-off was after the first one. That's what I'm seeing now. This is, you have to understand in real time, this is only a couple minutes. If you did a frame by frame, though, I want you to understand, I'm going to watch it again. Licking, licking, butt, curved head. That Max was an unusual case because there was no butt presenting, there was no curving of the head. It was just literally just sniffing him. It's trying to tell him they're actually going to make these dogs aggressive by doing this. It's trying to tell him okay, that second shake-off was later. Okay, here we go. Oh, my God. The second shake-off that I'm seeing was later. If you said you're going to get to that point, I'm almost to that point. I'll frame by frame as much as you can with this. Look at the dog's face. If you said that's a grimace, yes, that's a grimace. These are all preceding the shakeoff. He said that's the complete opposite of a dog looking at you. It's a dog sticking its ass in your face. This stuff is great. All right, and this is the headband thing I'm talking about. He said that looks very unnatural and that the leg lifting up is going with this headband thing. Yes. This is all happening in a split second, but that's what I call the wounded paw thing. If you just showed that to somebody and said, this is a boy comforting a dog that hurt its paw, it wouldn't believe. It's a very distinct bending of the head. Okay, now we got, you're going to get this. It's starting to rotate. Look at the feet. It's getting ready to start rotating. Look at the one front foot's already bent. Now, I want you to understand none of this is happening on a conscious level. Once the system takes over, it just happens. If you said all of these look like expressions of joy. No. All right, we got our head bending again and the paw up again. They don't see any of this. It's just startling. So that's the beginning of it right there. You see the paw is already lifting up. If you said that's what you're trying to say is that paw lifted up before this happened was the precursor, you really have to study this frame by frame. He said, why? Because they're operating on a faster plane than we are. The reaction time is faster. Everything's faster. If we could see things, if you said they're able to see all these little signals and stuff in other dogs as just as a normal function of living. Mm-hmm. And that we're too busy posting selfies and to notice any of this garbage. Oh, it really is. That's how they do it, though. It really. Oh, I know. Oh my God! It's called the shakeoff. You're gonna love this. I don't even want you to watch this stuff, girl. You need to just listen to it. You can picture it all in your mind as I'm talking. It's Taylor how to play with dogs. If you said, what is it? It's how to install the shakeoff. Video after video after video. If you said normal shakeoff, no, super shakeoff. It's unbelievable. All right, so there's the expression. This is what you're getting. You got your eyes closed, the leg is up. I want to try to stop it when its legs are off the ground. I mean, look at the face. If you said the body is very stiff, look how stiff the body is. This is right before the legs are getting ready to come off the ground. There's so much energy going back. God, it lifts them off the ground. I swear to God, this is them. This is the case. Look at the eye. Look at the look in the eyes. Looking right at Taylor when it does that, too. These are, if you said, how long is this shakeoff taking? I mean, it's, look at the ear. If you said, what would cause the ears to be out like that? Velocity. And I want you to understand right after that, look at how it's looking at Taylor. If I can freeze it on the part, its feet are actually off the ground, though. And you see that. I mean, you see it. Let me see if I can just freeze it on that part real quick. This is, if you said, what's it called? It's called the importance play. If somebody, they do, sitting on the floor, slapping them, patting them. You know, you've seen Taylor in action. Handsiest mofo I've ever seen. Anytime they do that lifting off the ground thing, the legs are real stiff. I mean, you don't want any of this stuff. They don't quite have it on YouTube where you can see stuff frame by frame yet. Anyway, after that, it does the shake off again. Look at these freeze frames, though. Look at the tail. If you said it's going to back away. Mm-hmm. Again, it's a typical Taylor lifeless dog. Anyway, I got to show you this other one real quick. The sneeze, I mean, all of them are good. All of them are good. If you watch this one closer, it might be doing the sneeze too. It's got all the precursors. There's the bent head. And they jump at you. If you said it looked like it sneezed right there. If you said, I want a trainer that does that. I mean, they're ruining this dog. You'll never get anything decent out of this thing. Oh, no, girl. I want you to go on there and look at it. Watch it in slow-mo. It's sneezing and shaking. And this dog's fixing to walk away and sneeze. Watch. If you said what happens after that, it proceeds to do the shake off. If you said while she's petting it, there is no more overt signal in dogs than the shake off, but these people don't see it. It's honestly startling. He's going to get somebody hurt. He's going to get somebody hurt. Watch. All right, I want you to watch. It's trying. There's the butt. If you said, I like one presenting its butt to my face, I don't. There's the curved head. That's the going at him. Grabs it by the neck. If you said feet went off the ground. If you said she keeps on. If you said they don't see that. If you said not like it's going to do it again, Kelly. Yeah, it is. If you said this short video, this dog is sneezing doing the shake off. And they're telling you that this is important to do. It's gone now. She's actually reaching for it. This is why I say don't sit on the ground in it. It's reactionary gapping her. Now it starts scratching. It's like, all right, let me show you this next guy though, real quick. This is honestly, this goes on and on and on. This is what Taylor is telling people to do. If you said, but what if I'm a girl? What if I'm small and my dog's going to be 100 pounds? What if I'm an older person that has disabilities? What if I'm this, that, and the other? What if I'm not a guy in his 40s? Oh my God, look. It's just so much fun. He's so quiet. He keeps looking like a puppy. He just looks like a classic mom. He's loving it. You're never going to see a shake-off like this anywhere, Kenneth. Hang on. Set your coffee down. Set your coffee down. You've never seen anything like this in your life. Said, why do they go back like that? It's a strategy. Bulldogs are notorious for it. If you said that's why people like them, yeah. The problem is you'll never get any animation any other time. And you already know that. All right, watch, get ready, girl. Get ready. Put your coffee down. If you said, I've never seen a shake off like that. It doesn't get any worse than that. If you said, if you had the shake rifle meter that King will be inventing 25 years from now, I'll be dead. But I'll be looking down from heaven saying, thank God he did it. If you said the shake rifle meter, here's what it called, King. The King-o-meter. I'll be dead. I won't know that he's my idea. I won't care. I want the best for you. Shake-o-meter. The King-o-shake-o-meter. Determined that... Shake a meter after running Taylor's footage to people. I want you guys to understand this is the most overt signal. If you say, give me an example of what it would be in a human being, fuck off. Fuck off. You make my skin crawl. Is that clear enough for you people? I'm sorry. I can't say this right quick. If somebody says something to you and walks away, if you said that's the opposite of saying of the Bill Armstrong effect, yes. It's the exact opposite. These people are a menace. This talk is reactionary gapping the guy, which is what they do when they're doing the zoomies, and people think it's funny, but it's basically the dog saying, you can't catch me. I stay if I keep you outside my reactionary gap. So I'm in control. I'm in control because I control the reactionary gap. They're not conscious of anything. You have to understand that the barrier we have between how we really feel and how we outwardly appear is language. No, I'm fine in it. This is me. I'm fine in it. Okay, but my words aren't really catching up to what I'm saying. If I wanted to... No, I'm fine. Don't worry. You know, I can add all kinds of emotions to this. If I'm conscious of it, no, I'm fine. Absolutely, I'm fine. Log off. That's the barrier that we have. We're able to do all these lies and everything because of language, because they don't have that. There's no filter. So they're not trying to hide anything. There's no reason to hide anything. The shake-off isn't a conscious thing, but it is a signal to other individuals. Yes, it is. And if you said who's notorious for not picking up on it, little puppies aren't aware of any kind of like social signals. They don't understand any of this. If they said they learn that if they continue to see the shake-off, that this is going to possibly proceed in an attack on their little ass. Yeah. It's the behavior. I'm going to send you a thing, Annette. What we don't understand is how much biology drives behavior. So if you said this shake-off thing is biological, is being biological driven by the system saying, reject. Yes, it's basically, you know, like when somebody gets like a transplant and their body rejects the transplanted organ or whatever. That's their body rejecting whatever's happening. These are their dogs that don't. I've got some that really do it. I really do. I've got some that it takes a great deal for them to do that. If you said physiologically, they're different. Yes. They're physiologically different. They're not saying, I'm not going to do the shake. I'm not going to let myself get irritated. I'm not going to do the shake-off. I'm just not going to do it. That's me saying I'm going to get irritated by this bad training, and I'm not going to say anything. I can consciously do it. I'm just going to still be irritated by myself. But I can consciously say that I'm not going to react. They're not able to do that because they don't have that barrier of language. So whatever they're physiologically feeling is just pouring out of them. You know, they might not want to act scared. If you said, what would they do? You know, if they're getting scared and everything, I mean, they're releasing all these pheromones. I mean, they may not try to tuck their tails, kindly, you know, like, keep the pheromones from, you know, coming out of their anal glands, but it doesn't work. I mean, that's the best that they can do. You know, they're not... They are honest in that way. I mean, you have to say, if you said dogs are honest, they absolutely are honest because they don't have that, they don't have any ability. If they could lie, they would. If you said, give me that, oh, you never fed me. You didn't feed me. If you said, mine does that now, that isn't really lying. It's just going to react to your, did I feed you? No, you feed me. But they're not, they are honest in that sense. So anything that you're seeing, you said, those dogs are just pretending to do the shake-off, Kelly. I used to have a horse that did tricks, and you could teach them. There's a way, if you look online, and that probably knows about this, but you can teach a horse to shake its head no. If you said, how do you teach him to do it? This is a book. It was this book called Movie Horses. I'm going to find it. It was how to train movie horses. And I remember that's how, really, honestly, it was the library. I can still remember it. I was very, very young, and it was this book called Movie Horses. And it talked about how, and I even found the book later, when I got older, but it was, I had to throw it out, I'm going to find another one though, but I remember, I mean, that's probably where it got started in animals, but the way that you trained them to shake their head no is they took a nail and they tapped on the middle of their, I can't remember what the thing is called, if you tell me in it, I'll remember the thing that their mane grows out of, whatever that bumpy thing is right there, it's out of their neck. Yeah. But that's how you would teach the horse to shake its head. No, you would tap it with a nail right there on the in the middle of the mane, and then it would shake its head. And then you get, you know, then that's how you teach it to shake its head. He said, you understood back then, that's how you got him to shake its head, but you didn't understand that. That was the show. I was 9 years old. How could I know that that's how it would work? We're getting bad signal, but anyway, that's what it is. They are honest. I can show you videos of the pig doing the shake-up. I've seen it in all kinds of animals, and I'm sure you have too. All you do is watch these nature videos, and they're all doing it. If you said all of these signals are a subtext, absolutely, they're all a subtext. They're not consciously being read by these individuals. They don't need to be. He said they're not consciously being read by us either. They don't seem to be. When every single video, there's the shake-off. For Taylor to put a compilation together, after I told him about the shake-off, he didn't know what it was. After somebody told you, he said, well, you're insane and drunk and on drugs. If I was drunk and on drugs, what these people should be saying is, what is she drinking? What are these drugs? And where can I get some? As quickly as possible. If they had any ability to attack my work, they would do that. Since they can't do that, I'm insane, mentally ill. If you said, like, a psychiatrist, no. Drunk and on drugs. If you said, but you're alive all day, every single day, when do you find the time? But if that were the case, it's like that bad mind, baby. I'll have what she said. The ability to study this book has given us the ability to get better fast. And I've got faith in you and that too. And if you said, you're a little, kind of put me out of your life, little things, a little tad that you do to people, and no, I think I do that to people in some ways. But if you said that you have to get all these other, you have to get all these, you have to get all the idiots out of your life. You really do. You really do. If you said like that old trainer I had and stuff, you do. You don't realize you're influenced by these people when they're around you. If you said if I was watching videos with cots every day, that I wouldn't really realize that subconscious that I was starting to become that. Pretty soon I'm coddled too. Yes. If you start to be influenced by the five people that you're around most, choose carefully. choose carefully. This from a person that has 5,000 friends. Those people. You've got to set a standard for yourself, I suppose, and understand that Fitch has given us the ability to get better very, very quickly. But you're going to have to commit time to studying it. You're going to have to get rid of your Netflix. And you're going to have to forget about whatever else is watching. I do it when I'm working out. I do an hour a day on the elliptical. And I listen to music. But I watch stuff in slow while I'm doing the elliptical. If you said if we filmed you while you're watching it, we'd be going, oh my God, it's riveting. When I'm watching this Taylor thing, it's like, it's like a Smith movie. It's like, okay, I see the shit coming. Here it comes. Here it comes. And he said, then I was like, oh my God. You know? And then he said everything else. And then he went back. This needs to be part of shake off the meter. He said, I thought it broke. He fixed it after that. I think if he went back, he said, take all the videos that I have. And they really need to learn right. If they let this film run, these are only 20, 30 seconds. Look how long this video is total. These are only 20 or 30 seconds is what you have to understand. And it's a 4 minute and 35 second video. And we've got two super shake-offs. The Pitbull, too, that would be three. The Pitbull had at least two shake-offs and a sneeze. The other dog had two shake-offs. The one, I mean, if you said a 4 minute video, it's terrifying. It's terrifying. And they're not just regular shake-offs. Regular shake-offs are easy to miss. And he said, I went back and frame by frame the shake-off videos. Look at the thumbnail. He said, you could tell a lot. Oh, absolutely. You can tell a lot from the thumbnails. I'm going to show you the tellers. They're all awful. Or maybe that was the last frame. It's just startling how bad they are. You can tell a lot by the thumbnails. Oh, this is the aggressive pickle. This is the aggressive Pitbull. That they, it's honestly that they don't. And listen, Taylor. Here, Taylor. Your clients know you're keeping these dogs. Me wanting to know why I had that Doberman in the crate, my personal Doberman. If you said, where's its training, Kelly? I'll show you its training, Taylor. You ain't seen nothing like it. This is the aggressive Pitbull. If you said, the person is literally 6 inches away. Anybody on the planet can walk a dog back and forth to a crate or to a pot. And stand there. These dogs are in crates with no blankets, no toys, and no dividers between the animals. If she moved around to try to get in front of it. I don't even believe anybody would keep animals like this. With no blankets, no toys, nothing. Might have all kinds of toys and blankets. Denise just bought a bunch of blankets because she's a high person. She's about Scylla, 8 years. They eat them all the time, though. If she's hyper-engaged. I don't understand why they think. I mean, I don't understand what they think that is. Anybody can stand to it just from a car. If you said they're only an inch and a half away, Kelly. Okay. Anybody can stand an inch and a half. That doesn't mean anything. If you said, what would you do with it? I'd get the whole thing in motion because that's where it's all going to go south. And get do some serious healing drills. So then when it saw something, you could kick it in the heel. That's your only hope. It really is. If you said, so if it started to say something, you kick it in the tail. If you said, then I'll go that way. If you said, then come right back at it and say, you understand that what happens when you see something in front of you is it's going, the whole dynamic is going this way. The second you see something in front of you, this is what happens every time. So that's what's going to happen. If you said, you feed the leash out and say, here's the leash. Video after video of it. You don't sit in my car. It's skillless. If you said anybody could take a dog on a leash and sit it on a car on a tree. This stuff is rich, though. If I was going to make a shake, here's a good idea. This is what you do to King. This is later. The king of Shaco meter has made millions. Every trainer out there wants one. And they're only 1999. Maybe she is crazy. It's true, though. I think you could do a computer program that could read behavior. Don't you think that? It's also textbooky. We're not looking at dogs having all these wide range of. We're looking like people where you're having, you've got extremes of behaviors that they have, but they do really have a set behavior set. You're not looking at individuals that are just, that does that flip. If you said, what about, you're getting it, obviously, it's a lot more complexity, you're getting schizophrenia and all these, things going on. But, you're getting extremes of the behaviors that they have, but you're not getting, things that are outside of that behavior set. You're really not. It's all very textbook. Even people, most people, if you just look at the average people, their behavior is going to be reasonably textbook. Oh, I can tell you why. I can tell you exactly why. I don't have a problem cutting people out of my life. One, because that Oprah thing, but two, I was getting mixed all the time. So you really didn't have any choices. Like, if it was us, like, said goodbye. No, my dad wasn't there for us. It was the Cold War. And so we moved all the time. If you said, because the government thought the Russians were going to bomb us, yeah. Absolutely. So we were out to different places. So there's all these bombs and stuff, so we could bomb back. Because it was all just. The rest of their silos were rusty. They didn't have money to bomb us. I mean, at least I can understand. I'm going to go to the psychologist to understand why don't I care? Why don't I care? He said, what if these people want their way back into their life? Then I said, they deserve to be the man. Who would put that much effort into it unless they really cared? That's like, that's me. I don't want to be like that, but I can understand why I'm like that. He said, what I was saying as a child, sure. Don't leave all your friends behind after 3 years. He said you'd have like best friend, but he said then you figure out you have other friends. Anyway, that was a very, very. This guy, I say all the time, is the king of the shakeup. I mean, that's about as extreme as it gets. If you said people are so unaware. Oh, this is apparently. I mean, this is bad here. I mean, that's bad. If you said that's in no way going to contribute. The last thing you want, I've never seen anyone. If you said that's reactionary gapping, yes. People call it the zoomies. There's the but. It looks honestly like it's got the hair. There's reactionary gapping going over there, looking for something to do. Let's run a drop out. This is another good one. I've got other videos of it, but if you said I saw a flash of it, I absolutely saw a flash of it. Hang on. There's something that dogs do, and it's all drop out. I'm going to freeze it. It's in the butt. It's going to come back. It's going to be the drop tail. If you said, what does the drop tail mean? What I've seen it mean is, oh, there it was. I don't have any choice that I'm going to have to. I'm going to find videos that I got, because there's some of them you've seen before, Annette, where you get to all the way, it starts kind of doing the zoomies thing. It's usually like a young, naive dog, and the other dogs start chasing it. In a game called Let's Kick Your Ass. So it continues to keep running, doing the zoomies, as they get more and more serious chasing it. It's becoming more and more aware of this, understanding there isn't any escape, and that whatever's going to happen, it's going to happen. That's the drop tail. And I'm going to show it to you. It's very, very distinct. Because the top of the tail, it goes out about that much, and then the tail drops. I call it drop tail. Again, it's starting to happen right here. It's starting to happen. You're not conscious of this. So I want you to understand this. It's starting to happen right there. And okay, there it was. And I want you to look at what the guy is doing when it's starting to happen. If he said there's no flashes like before that, but put it in slow mo. You got to do it so someone really see it. It's a very, very. There it was. Down. It's all over the place. It's been my opinion. Every time I've seen it, is when they have said to themselves, it's foregone conclusion. Let me face it right on the exact drop, because it's starting to drop. It's a very, very distinct. There'll be some. The one I got one video of it, where it starts doing it. Because I did this, there's a very degree of drop. This dog was just convinced. He said that wasn't really what was going to happen, but that's what it thought. Let's get what happened right there. I want you to understand they're not conscious of any of these things. It's just happening in reflection to what's, what they're seeing. Okay, so this is the freeze frame. Look at this guy. So it's getting ready to happen. You see the top. You see the top of the tail. When they have the drop tail thing, it's only from there down that it's coming down. The base part. Well, not much of the base will still go. We freeze it right on it. Look at these freeze frames. If you just look at that, the dog is trying to get me. Yeah. He said, should we do any of these things? Please put your coffee down yet. Please, quickly sit your coffee down. Hot coffee. Look at this, though. Shouldn't you be trained dogs? There's a circa in the training. Oh, there it was. You're not conscious of it. Look at this. He said that's the butt and the head hurt at the same time. Make sure when you watch this thing, you watch. Watch the tail. Right there. Dodge is made. was flashing in between, but it was very distinct right there. If you said that, if you really frame by frame, there's a lot more drops than you're able to really see. Yep. Because I'm seeing, I just keep seeing the flashes of it. He slaps it on the ass and now runs away. I'll find that drop shot video though. It's honestly where it's like I've every strategy I don't have anything else to come up with, so it's gonna happen. Whatever's gonna happen is gonna happen. It's so honest. If you said that they don't see the shake off, they're not gonna see the drop tail. If you said if you did frame by frame of this, it'd just be beyond bizarre. He now hits it. See the tail starting to droop. Oh, hi, Dorothy. Oh, this is monster again. That's what they do to these dogs. Get on the, he said, should I get on the floor with Rocky? No. Hits it again. Play bounce. If you said, do you want one? No, that's the last thing. You're getting ready to reactionary gap them. If that's what they do to other dogs and they do the playback, absolutely. You can catch me. You said that other dogs try. Look at this. Now it's gone. Now watch for the drop tail. It's only going to happen in the frame. Right there. It's running and dropped here. I'm not consciously doing any of these things. It's this guy's literally hitting it in the shoulder. It does not know what to do. So it comes up this. If you said this play out and drop here, and go, oh, absolutely. Look at these doggy dare care videos. You see it all the time when some new dog comes and starts getting overwhelmed, and they're saying, oh, it's playing. If you say, no, they're running, drop. He jumps around by Taylor. He knows what he's all about. It's size away from him. There's your drop tail. So now there he is, big wide arms off to the side. And there's your drop. Watch this tail. Gone. It was looking for something. They're looking for something. It saw there was no escape. Look at the tail. Look at the tail. Do you see it, Annette? This is very hard to see without reviewing it several times. So you people need to understand. This stuff is very, very hard to see. Let me freeze frame it on that, though. He said that was a direct result. The play bow. This is something called textbook. He said, I've got all kinds of videos. I did a whole series at one time of dog behavior. I'll go find it because I'm sure there's some. It's already dropped tailing right there. I mean, it's just honestly, who would hit one like that? I want you to watch very, very closely. There's the play bow. If you said I start to see a little drop, it's a very distinct slaps it. Gone. It goes over by Taylor, but it says, no, this motherfucker's the same deal. Look, it looks like it does a shake off when he sees him. Yeah, he says, I know what this motherfucker's all about. The reactionary gap, this guy, too. Go on. I want you to watch the tail. He said, it almost looks like the hair is up. Look. This is the drop tail. Watch. And it goes over here. It goes over there. It's looking for something. If there had been a dog or anything over there, it would have gone over there. But it sees there's nothing over there. It now comes back. Watch there. You see it? You see it? You see it? Oh my God, it's so classic. Let me freeze it on that. Because it's always this much of the tail is sticking out and the rest of the tail's hanging down. And again, none of these things are conscious. It's not, it does not want to feel this way. They don't have any strategy. They don't have, it actually walked away. It walked away from Taylor and did a shake off. It now avoids it. I'm going to freeze it. It's already starting to drop. You guys, this is what you need to understand. Film has given us the ability to get rid of it. This is just a classic drop. There it was. And that's what these people do when they had that bombing in Manchester. Any of you guys that are from the UK, remember that Ariana Grande concert? 16,000 hours of footage. If you said they went frame by frame, yes, they did. Yes, they did. They have these people called super recognizers. I could make this stuff up. Who are able to see a person in a crowd and watch footage and recognize that person again. And by reviewing this 16,000 hours of footage, frame by frame, they were able to figure out what happened. I want you to understand, it's starting to drop right here, but there's a very... A lot of times, it is doing the side-to-side thing before it drops. It's... so classic. The fact that they don't understand, I'm going to freeze it right on the... You know, if you said, how do they do the frame by frame thing? Well, YouTube is not quite, you don't quite have the ability to do... If you said, if you downloaded it, you could do it frame by frame. If I download it, maybe I will do that. If I download it, then I can do it frame by frame, because I can do screen grabs of every frame. But it's very distinct. Oh, man. I want you to watch the tail. Don't look at anything but the tail. Start to bend right there. It's losing it right there. It goes over, remember, it goes over the corner. There's nothing to do. Start looking at right there. You saw it. Look at it drop. The end is, if you see the end of the tail, looks, if you know what that thing is, cold water tail. Do you know what that is, Annette? Courtney knows what it is. There's something called cold water tail, where the muscles, those same muscles in their tail, whether they get exhausted or something, and then the tail hangs limp like that. If you say, they usually recover, but that's what it looks like. It on appearance, it's all over this dog now that I look at it. It's, you can see it coming, but that's what it looks like. The top part of the tail. The top part right there, then the rest of it hangs down. It's not consciously doing that. If you said the end of its tail is just bent down, you said that looks really unnatural and weird. How is that even possible? How is that possible for that dog's tail to be like that? you didn't look at the look on his face. It's very distinct. I've got that dog down here. I used to do it. I think it was him. I got one video of this thing on his rock tail all over the fucking yard. Nobody was even chasing him. That was the part. They're kind of like half-heartedly chasing him, but that's classic drop tail right there, though. It's not a tuck tail because they're always this tuck part's always sticking out. But the end part is limp. If you set it in, it'll start sort of curling under. It will sort of start curling under, but it's generally not really tucked. It's kind of, I'm going to show it to you again, because it's here again. I mean, again, if you said, that just looks strange. Classic. Look at the tail. If you said that's drop tail, absolutely. That's a classic drop tail. If you said the end of the tail is limp, it's hanging on its leg. I mean, some people call it flaccid tail, I call it drop tail, but look at it, that's what it looks like. If you said that's it running away from the guy. If you says that saying stand down, it's best it can. I'd gladly pay to have somebody do this with my dog. Oh, there we went. There goes the drop tail. They're not consciously doing it. This is what you need to understand. And if you're not, look, I just randomly froze it. And there's the drop tail. He said, well, it looks like a guy's coming after him. So what do you want the dog to do? That's just a random moving thing. If you said you're trying to explain this is a stop tail behavior. Yes. Look at the tail. Look at the tail. If you said the end of the tail's limp. If you said, would anybody want to play with the size of a dog like this? It's half-heartedly trying to come up with something. There's your tail again. If you said it's backing up, yes. If you said he's not going to let it go. You can grab it its head, just like another dog would. Gone. Sees Taylor and does the shake off again. Drop tail. Oh, it already knows what Taylor's about. It looks like it's got the hair up. It really does. Unless it's just the lighting. It's approaching with it going.
It's supposed to be the swing, the side swing tail is what I call it. So it's rather have to go sit on the cot than be by this guy. That's fucking sad. Run away from Taylor. Any dog knows what he's about. Okay, now he's sitting spread-legged on the floor. She said they mistake this lick. And you see Priscilla do that to me all the time. She said that's another strategy. Yeah, absolutely. The dog Lucy does it too. That's why those people originally had Lucy. That always looks all the time. If that's her strategy, oh, absolutely. She doesn't do it to me, but they always petting her all the time. So she's coming. As soon as they started doing the petting, it started doing the looking. If you said that, then they stop. Yeah, they will. It's just beyond incompetence. These are all great chickens. Here, this is what you would do, King, though. This is my other idea. You get your favorite song that has a good beat, and you edit out all these shake-offs and set it to music. It would probably go viral. Get your kids to college on that shit, King. Yeah. Viral video of dogs doing the shake-off set to music. You said people would think it was hilarious. Yes? I didn't know what it meant. Just be dog shaking and laughing. You see how easily entertain these idiots on Facebook are. All right, listen, I'm going to see if I can get some stuff done, but that was today's lesson. I mean, I think if you went and looked at videos where they were doing the shake off, if you really had a lot of footage to look at, you would be able to see the sneeze. If you said, I wanted to find the sneeze, where would I look? I would say the first place would probably start looking for videos where you saw the shake off. Because if you looked closer, you'd see the sneeze. The most overt signal the dogs have was shake off. Other than growling and barking, you know what I mean? It's if you said, I don't see it, you can point it out to anybody and they see it. You can point it out to anybody and they see it. They just, it would be like going to another country and saying, fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. But then not knowing what that meant. You know, so that's basically what it is. If you said it's never a good thing, it really isn't. It is. I tell you what, it is a good thing, and this is what you need to want to learn about in that. But it's a good thing, and I've got tons of videos of this too. If you've got a dog that's forcing itself on another dog, you want to add the nick as though it's the other dog doing it until the dog that's doing it does the shake off. If you said why, because that's telling the dog's subconscious, this individual is repulsive. This individual is repulsive. So this dog is hammering. I'm getting ready to do that because I got a couple that are hammering these other dogs. Hammering this other dog. You're adding a nick every time this dog hammers. Hammer, nick. Pretty soon this hammering isn't getting quite the payoff. But it was, because instead of getting the dopamine, every time we're doing that, it's getting hit with the nick. If you said, then what happens? The dog stops, and then it does the shake-up, and you know that you did it right. If you said, because it's saying to itself, I'm going to do the arms length thing. Here's what I'll do. I'll do the arms length thing from this individual, just like I do with people when they cause the shake-off in me. So if you said, then you'll now have a dog that'll leave that little dog alone because it's developed the arms length. And it wouldn't be the arms length, but it's the same syndrome. Because on a subconscious level, this dog, there's no payoff. It's going to stay an arm's length away from that dog because of that affect. Absolutely because of that affect. So if you said, I need to see videos,
Don't you worry, girlfriend. I got them falling out of my pockets. I've got one about the humping. And so it's out there. You're just adding it. You're not saying anything. You're not really even looking. They're not looking at you. If it's happening every time, if every time I touch this thing, I get a static electric shock. And I know that that's what's going to happen, but I just still keep touching it. Eventually, I said, I'm sorry for touching it. I don't want to touch it anymore. Not just everything's fine as I'm going to touch it. It's life. How's your life, Kelly? Fine as long as I don't touch this thing. That's avoidance training at the best. Everything is fine as long as I don't touch this thing. What happens is, I know exactly what happens when I touch this. So I stay at arm's length away. In order to be safe, Annette, in order to be safe, I stay at arm's length away from it. Then it really can't do anything. If you said in the unlikely event it started to move towards you, yeah? Mm-hmm. Then you have to get away from it. Listen, I'm going to maybe see if I can get something done, but if not, I'm just going to, I got a couple of little things in store. I might just admit it's a girl, because I'm not going to make excuses.